welcome to the fifth grade Witch of Forest concert. We're really excited for what's going to happen this evening. And Abby's going to start our show.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to our fifth grade winter choir concert. Our fantastic fifth graders from Woodland Park and Mines pair our selection of music to help you celebrate this holiday season this summer. But we open our concert with Who Is in the Wind, a poem written by Christina Rossetti, set to melody written by Carol King. We first learned how to sing this melody using solfege, discovering that it has a lot of minor tonality. We then experimented with different ways to turn this melody to a canon, when two more groups sing the same thing, but started different times. Enjoy the results so our fifth grade course creativity takes the melody and turn into much more.
Thank you.
have been overtaken by the cold winter weather, we are ready to celebrate the many holidays of the season. Our next piece for you is a partner song that features a traditional Christmas song combined with a new melody. Although you might recognize a familiar tune, Audrey Cinder has changed the meter and added some unexpected syncopation to give a new twist in her version of Christmas Welcome.
Music and spend more time singing in a small group. These singers audition to be part of the ensemble and rehearse every Thursday morning before school. Their first piece for you is called White Fields by Mary Donnelly and George L. O'Stride. Listen as we describe the beauty and wonder of fresh snowfall featuring a canon as well as two-part harmony.
Snow is falling, gently falling. piece the small ensemble will perform for you is Cold of Winter, another piece full of beautiful imagery by John Purefoy. This mysterious sounding melody describes the harsh and biting cold of the winter air, emphasized by a minor tone. This piece also challenged our small ensemble to sing in two parts and use crisp, sharp consonants to enhance the mood of the music.
Written by Dave and Jean Perry, Snowtime Fantasy. In this piece, you will hear two distinct melodies about the fun and excitement of a winter snowfall. Listen for how well the two melodies complement each other when they are combined to create beautiful harmony.
Thank you. performed by the full chorus, featuring several chorus members singing in small groups. Dodi Li is an Israeli song arranged by Doreen Rayo after visiting Jerusalem and being inspired by the spirit and musicality of the young Israeli singer she met. We use solfege to learn this piece, once again discovering a minor tonality to the melody. Our chorus was also challenged to perform this piece in the traditional Hebrew language. Listen for two complementing melodies alternating with contrasting verses performed by our small groups.
Which means grant us peace. Finally, the chorus will combine both melodies into beautiful harmony.
Thank you. As we near the end of our program, the winds have blown, the snow has fallen, and now it is time to take advantage of all the fun that winter has to offer. Our chorus will now take you on a winter sleigh ride written by Dave and Jean Perry. This song features a minor melody as well as a lot of complicated syncopated rhythm patterns. Listen for how our chorus was challenged to sing two simultaneous melodies in the refrain of this piece.
Thank you all for coming to the 5th grade chorus winter concert and kicking off the holiday season with us. Your support of the music program at McKnight Elementary is so important. We will be closing our program this evening with How Can I Keep From Singing. It's a Quaker song arranged by Ginger Littleton. The text of this piece is powerful, reflecting one of the main purposes in life, to rise above the problems and sorrows we might experience and find an inner calm and peacefulness. No matter how uncertain life is, there is a constant song throughout, if only we seek to hear it and to sing it.
Thank you.
for being with us here this evening. And I don't think we've ever had a standing O at a fifth grade chorus concert before, so wow. There is something about that last song that is just so powerful, and to hear their beautiful voices singing those words, they got me, I don't know if they got you, but wow. I do have a few thank yous I need to say, that we need to say, for making this performance possible. And you can hold your applause until I finish the list. So first, to Mr. Marsh and the custodial staff, they turned our cafeteria into our cafetorium for the evening, so thanks to them. Also, a thank you to Mr. Morton, our orchestra teacher, who helped our violinists and also recorded our concert this afternoon and did some other help setting up the stage. Also to Mr. Krause, our band teacher, who set up our whole sound system, also helped set up our stage. We wouldn't sound as lovely without his sound equipment. And also to Mrs. Monahan, the best music teaching partner I could ever ask for. She's always there, no matter what I need, and it's awesome. And also to Dr. Shu, and Mrs. Hudson, as always, for their support of music here at McKnight. So thank you to all of those people. And of course, the fabulous accompanist, Mr. Reese, my father-in-law. It's always great to have him. The biggest thank you, though, has to go to all of you for sharing your children and their beautiful talent with me. It really is a blessing to get to work with them. They are awesome. They sound great, and I'm so thrilled that I get one more concert with them. Although, if I had my wish, they would never leave fifth grade.